we therefore use this information in order to develop a DNA analysis tool to monitor where antimalarial drug resistance occur and how it spread. My name is Mallika Imbong from Faculty of Tropical Medicine, Mahidol University. According to information from the World Health Organization, the COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted malaria prevention, diagnosis, and treatment service, leading to 14 million more malaria cases in year 2020 compared to year 2019, and 60,000 more deaths. Malaria is a vector-borne disease transmitted by mosquito. There were about 240 million malaria cases and 600,000 malaria deaths worldwide in year 2020. The WHO malaria strategy aimed to cut malaria incident and mortality by 90% by year 2030. However, one major obstacle to malaria elimination is antimalarial drug resistance. Southeast Asia is where drug resistance in Plasmodium falciparum emerged, as it happened twice in the past for chloroquine and sulfadoxine pyrimethamine. Chloroquine and sulfadoxine pyrimethamine resistance has developed and originated in the Thai-Cambodia border and then subsequently spread to other parts of the world, which result in a million children die in Africa. Artemisinin is the best malaria treatment. Artemisinin combination therapy is the first line drug for uncomplicated malaria. However, artemisinin resistance has already developed in Plasmodium falciparum, and it caused by mutation in the gene named KELCH, which is located on chromosome 13. We therefore use this information in order to develop a DNA analysis tool to monitor where antimalarial drug resistance occur and how it spread. In summary, we found that PF KELCH mutation at position 580 is very common in East Greater Mekong sub-region, including Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, and Vietnam. And this mutation is associated with artemisinin resistance. Furthermore, there is no evidence of spread from the eastern to the western of the Greater Mekong sub-region. This information is extremely important to the WHO and National Malaria Program. It helps in decision making and implementing a national treatment guideline for malaria patients in order to eliminate malaria in this region. Thank you very much to all the collaborators and colleagues for your support. It is not possible without you. And if you are interested to learn more about this project, please scan QR code at the end of the video clip.